YouTube. Today I'm going to show you how to play Counting Stars by Onerepublic, and this is a request. So first I'm quickly going to show you what it's hopefully going to sound like. And then, like, I'll show you the strumming that goes with that. So yeah, basically that's hopefully what you'll be able to play by the end of this song, this tutorial even. It's one of those days. So to play the song, you're going to need a capo on 4, and you're going to need the chords A minor, C, G, and F, or this version of F. So if you know how to play those chords, skip ahead, and if you don't, keep watching. So high E string, string 1, low E string, string 6. So first of all, to play A minor, you put your first finger on the 2nd string, 1st fret, your middle finger on the 4th string, 2nd fret, and your ring finger on the 3rd string, 2nd fret. Now, to get from A minor to C, all you do is you just move your ring finger to the 5th string, 3rd fret. So you've got A minor, move your ring finger, and then voila, it's a C. Cool, so the next chord you need is G. So you put your first finger on the 5th string, 2nd fret. I lied, because I totally told the truth. Anyway, so you put your first finger on the 5th string, 2nd fret, your middle finger on the 6th string, 3rd fret, your ring finger on the 2nd string, 3rd fret, and your little finger on the 1st string, 3rd fret. Yeah, I'm going to put all of these in like little kind of annotation boxes around my head, so make sure you've got your annotations turned on, because hopefully that might help. So yeah, then there's two versions of F you can play. You can play this like mini bar F, or this, no, I like, you can play 4 bar F or mini bar F. If you want to the picking pattern, you've got to play 4 bar F, but apart from that, you can just play mini bar F for the rest of the song. So to play 4 bar F, what you do is you bar all the strings at the 1st fret with your 1st finger. You put your middle finger on the 3rd string, 2nd fret, your ring finger on the 5th string, 3rd fret, and your little finger on the 4th string, 3rd fret. Cool, then to play mini bar F, what you do is you bar the 1st and 2nd string at the 1st fret with your 1st finger. You put your middle finger on the 3rd string, 2nd fret, and your ring finger on the 4th string, 3rd fret. So you've got 4 bar F, and then mini bar F. So, all the chords all the way through now, you've got A minor, C, G, and then either a 4 bar F or a mini bar F. So yeah, so first of all, there's basically one main chord pattern all the way through this song. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you the chord pattern and the strumming pattern, and then I'll do the picking pattern at the end. So yeah, so this chord pattern all the way through, you've got an A minor, a C, a G, and then an F. And you hold each of those chords for 4 beats. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 4. So yeah, strumming pattern wise, you can do the strumming pattern like the whole way through, apart from the bit in the middle, which is like Take That Money, Watch It Burn, where you can literally just down strum on the A minor. But yeah, the strumming pattern I'd recommend sounds like this. Is down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up. Yeah, so what I'm going to do, I'm just quickly going to play that with a bit of the song for you, and then I'll teach you the picking pattern. So if you don't want to learn the strumming pattern, that's the whole song done. I swear this is easily like the quickest tutorial I've ever done. I mean, I talk a lot though, so generally my teaching is about 60% and my talking is 40%. Anyway, so yeah, that's the strumming pattern for the whole song. Like I said, unless you get to the middle bridge bit, where all you can do is just downstrum on A minor. So yeah, anyway, to play the picking pattern, I'll just quickly just remind you what that sounds like. So So yeah, the great thing about the speaking pattern is most of it kind of stays the same. The only thing that changes is like the first string you pluck. And the pattern kind of shifts around on the strings, but the pattern is still kind of the same. But I'll just explain that. So what you do, if you put your fingers in the shape of an A minor, the first string you pluck is string 5. Then you pluck string 3. Then 2 and 1 together. And then 3 again. So you just have 5, 3, 2 and 1, then 3 again. And then that repeats twice on each chord. So you just have for this A minor, 5, 3, 2 and 1, 3, 5, 3, 2 and 1, 3. So without me, my delicate tones, talking over the top of it. And then you put your fingers in the shape of a C. And that is exactly the same picking pattern again, just with the C. And then you repeat it, then you repeat that kind of picking twice as you did in the A minor. This is where you kind of change it up a bit. For a G, what you do is the first string you pluck is string 6, and then you pluck string 4, 2 and 3 together, and then 4. So 6, 4, 2 and 3, 4, and then that repeats again. So from the beginning, like with the A minor, you start on string 5. Then you shorten your fingers to an F, and it's exactly the same. Well, I lie, it's not. So instead, you pluck string 5 first, and then 4, 2, and 3, 4. So it's kind of like half the G picking pattern mashed up. So on that F, you've got string 5, 4, 2, and 3, 4, and then you repeat it again. So from the beginning of that whole picking pattern. Oops, fail. Oh my god, I'm mucking this up. I'm sorry. Right, take two. From the beginning of that pattern. And yeah, so basically that just repeats like the whole way through for the intro, and then you can actually play that through the whole song, except for when it gets a bit more goey, you just kind of speed it up. So yeah, basically that's the whole song. So yeah, please comment, please rate, please subscribe, please request. My lesson for the day, I mean, not gonna lie, this year at uni I have like 9 contact hours a week, and I don't normally go to all of those 9, which is very bad, because anyone who's watching, you totally should go to all your lectures, but sometimes, you know, I just can't be bothered. I wake up in the morning and I'm just like, not feeling uni today, so I sit around and play guitar. Anyway, so yeah, my lesson for the day from some of the lectures that I've been to is, yesterday in physiology, because I went to a lecture yesterday and it was fun, we learned about Mike the Headless Chicken, who apparently, like, in the 1950s or something, some farmer was, like, trying to behead his chicken. Anyway, so he chopped the head off, but then, like, left a bit of the brainstem intact, so this chicken could still totally, like, breathe and walk and, like, step, like, over obstacles, even though it had, like, no head. It was kind of cool. Anyway, and yeah, so then, like, Mike then went through, like, a tour of all the state fairs in America, which is exciting. But then I think he died by choking on his food, which is sad for Mike. But apparently there's a festival for Mike. Anyway, but yeah, so that's everything. So yeah, please comment, please rate, please subscribe, and please request.